You can set Photoshop to record everything you do automatically. Anything you do in Photoshop can be recorded as a written instruction or tutorial. You can also choose to share it with your team members, other people, students, or keep it as a record. And this is how you set it up. So here we are in Photoshop, and first of all, we need to determine where the instructions are saved. So on Windows, let's go to Edit and then Preferences. On a Mac, that would be under Photoshop and then Preferences. Now inside of Preferences, click on History Log. Just turn this on. So where do you want the information to be saved? Do you want it to be saved as a metadata, which means inside the PSD file itself, embedded to the PSD file, or as a separate text file? So if you choose a separate text file, you can choose where to save it. I'm just going to hit cancel right now. And what I prefer is both. So I'm going to choose both. So that way it's going to save it inside the PSD and also as a separate text file. So let's choose both. Now when you choose both, you need to decide the location of the text file. So I'm just going to save it in History Log folder and name it PixImperfect Edit Log. Hit Save. Now it's time for us to decide how much of the information we want Photoshop to record. So if you choose Sessions Only, in the instructions it will only have session information. For instance, when the file was opened, when was it saved, when it was opened again, and when was it saved again, so on and so forth. And we don't want that. We also don't want concise information. We want detailed information. So let's choose Detailed and hit OK. Now, whatever you do in Photoshop with this file or any other file you ever open, as long as the history log is checked, it will keep on recording it. So let's say we create a curves adjustment layer. You know, it's my favorite. Let's just bump up the contrast and then just bump up the shadows a little bit, create a faded effect. Now let's create a vibrance adjustment layer. Click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose vibrance. Let's increase the vibrance just a bit to add some color to it. And let's save this photo. Press Ctrl or Command S. Now if I go to my Finder, you will notice this text file. Let's open that up. Let's see what it says. Have a look at it. It gives you all the steps. New curves layer was made. It modified the curves layer. I accidentally created a hue saturation layer, so on and so forth, each and every detail. And at the end, it was saved. See, it was saved and it was closed too. So everything you do inside of Photoshop, it will save it. So even if you create a new document, so let's go ahead, choose Photoshop, and let's go to File, New, and let's create a new document, 1920x1080. And let's create a new layer on top of it and let's paint something on it, right? And on top of that, create a curves or levels adjustment layer and move stuff here and there. And if I save it, Control or Command S, and save it as a different file format, and this is test one, and let's save it not as a PSD, even if I save it as, let's say, a JPEG. Save. All right, let's save it and let's have a look at it. Let's have a look at the text file. It should have it. Have a look. A new layer was created. Make layer, select brush with the brush tool. I did something. And every detail is saved there. Even in the levels adjustment layer, what did I do? So input was 8025, gamma was 0.35. And there you go. It has all the details. If you just simply learn how to read this and follow along, you'll be able to do that as well. So you can share this with anyone you like. Now, besides the text file, you have one more thing. If you open up that PSD again, which we just saved, even the PSD will have all of the information saved inside of that PSD. So have a look at it. It's already opened. Example PixImperfect. If I go to File, and inside of File, let's go to File Info right there. And then let's choose Photoshop. It will have all the details. Modify curves layer. So the first point was 0, 0. Second point is 9484. It has all the details, all the changes we made just to this file. So I prefer both of them. I prefer a separate text file, which keeps a record of all the PSDs that I open and edit and save, and also PSD files having their history embedded in them. So that was pretty much it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe. Ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tip, trick, or tutorial. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.